The Stingray is dead and I guess long live the Stingray. If you don't know what I'm talking about, let's find out together. This is Gregor from bassdemo.com, and yes, you've heard right, Music Man has actually retired the Stingray bass the way they made it over the last 40 years. Obviously, it's not entirely gone, because as you can guess, there's a replacement, and of course it's also called the Stingray. I have it right here, and that's what we're checking out today. There's a lot of things that have changed with these basses, and but first of all, I think it's a very brave move for Music Man to pull something like this off. I don't think many brands would have the guts to do something like this, and let's start with the good news right away. The Stingray is definitely a better bass now. Every time something like this is happening, there's of course a bunch of traditionalists crying over the good old days and how everything used to be better in the 80s or whatever. If you're one of those guys, don't be afraid, there's of course still the classic series basses that you can buy from Music Man that are built in the old shape, with all the parts, you know, you will be happy with those. For everyone else who's not afraid to move forward with our life and also with traditional basses, let's check this one out. For this review, we have the Stingray 4-string and we have a 4-string HH with two humbuckers and an ebony fingerboard. First thing everyone will notice when picking one of these up is how lightweight they are compared to the previous models. The new Stingrays weigh all something around 3.6 kilos, which are 8 pounds. This is by any standard very light for a 4-string bass. This was achieved by changing a couple of things. First of all, we have a slimmer shape. The edges are much rounder now and the bass also feels a tiny little bit slimmer in general. The neck isn't a baseball bat anymore, it's still not an Ibanez, but it's a lot more comfortable to me than any of the old neck shapes. Also, they changed the hardware entirely. The bridge and the tuners are made from aluminum now, which saves a lot of weight. One of the things I like the most about the redesign is how the new tuners feel. They're thicker in the middle now, and when I used them for the first time, I thought this is exactly what tuners should feel like. The electronics department also got a complete update. The pickups now come with neodymium magnets and the electronics were revoiced and are running on 18 volts now to give you more headroom and a cleaner tone. Of course, like probably most other people, I was skeptic at this first, but I think it didn't even take me a minute of playing this bass to realize that even though they changed the pickup and the electronic, they were able to maintain and to keep the traditional characteristic and the traditional sound of the Stingray, and they didn't mess with this at all. Another big change is the body neck transition. With the old models, this was a really chunky part, and look what I've done now. It's much easier to play the highest frets now, and to celebrate this, Music Man has added one more, and yes, the Stingray has 22 frets now. The Stingray bodies are made from swamp ash and the new necks are all roasted maple now, and this is actually a great choice, because during this roasting process, the raisins in the neck harden out and make this neck behave like basically a really, really old and bone dry piece of wood, and those usually have very beautiful characteristics acoustics when it comes to resonance, and this is something that you really can hear when you're playing this bass, and also this neck looks very, very pretty. So let's check the pickup sounds of the Stingray 4HH. Those were all the facts and specifications, but I think what the redesign of the Stingray really means mainly is something that you will rather feel when you have one in your hand and you're playing one. Of course, it feels a little bit different, but that's not even the main change. I would say the main change, the main news for the Stingray is something, and not even sound, it's more like sound behavior. I would say the new Stingrays are a little bit faster, they're a little bit punchier, they have a little bit more top end, which is really nice. And also, and this is almost confusing, they sound older than the previous models. And this, I think this is mainly because of the roasted maple, because of the special sound characteristic that this is putting in the space. And I think all in all together, it just works very well and it sounds just beautiful. Oh, and by the way, Lars is one of the biggest music men and Stingray nerds that I know. So let's hear what he has to say.
Hi, everybody. It's Lars. Usually it's Gregor who's doing the talking, but now it's my turn, apparently, because music man and myself, we do have a really long history together. I've been endorsing the instruments forever, and I'm pretty much blown away by the new Stingrays, I must confess. The necks feel great. The neck joint is just incredible, and also the new pickups in conjunction with the modified electronics, that's a real killer who gives you a kick in the butt, and it's really great fun, and I can't wait to get mine.
My conclusion for this review is basically Ernie Ball and the Music Man guys are just a bunch of geniuses. I mean, not everyone has the balls to take such an old traditional bass and change it all up and put it back on the market, and then it works, and then it's really good, and it's better than the previous models. I mean, that's something that honestly we don't get to see every day, and I think it's a very ballsy move from Music Man. I think it just went actually very, very well. And honestly, if I went out to buy a Stingray today, and even if money was no object at all, I wouldn't even dare to find one of those old amazing vintage Stingrays, because this is definitely the best Stingray that I've ever heard, that I've ever played, and I mean, just amazing job, Music Man. Congratulations. That's it for today. If you enjoyed this review, don't hesitate to click the like button below, and if you have any questions, just leave them in the comments section below. If you want to see more, subscribe to this channel, and I guess that's it for today. See you next time, and have a wonderful week. Bye bye.